Now, I'm in here watching the movie Time Machine. But before I go into the video, we're gonna do some quick research. Jump out! King! Work with me right quick. Work with me, because I got to jump out of this real quick and we're gonna come back to it. And I'm gonna come back to it. Because I wanna go right here. All right. We'll start right here. So I was doing some research, right? Let me blow this up a little bit for y'all can see it a little bit. So I was doing some research, right, on missing people after I was watching that movie. And it says, according to the FBI, in 2019, there were 4,021 394 missing children in 2018. The total number of missing children and tires into NCIC was 400,024 and 66. So almost a half a million children is missing in just in the US. Now listen to this. This number represents the reported missing children. That means if a child runs away multiple times in a year, each insist would be entered into the NCIC separately and counted in the total yearly total. Likewise, if the entry is withdrawn and a mandate was updated, that would also reflect in the total. So, just say 20,000 of these are children that run away, and they count that multiple times, and they count that into the grand total. But look at here, though. I want to go to the. Let me see. Go to the next slide. Okay. Now, I'm gonna show y'all. Hold on, cause I want to go to the top first, right here. I'm gonna show y'all. These is the top states with the most missing people, period. And I'm looking, Alaska got the most missing people. And I'll be like, no wonder Discovery Channel always be playing them missing shows and shit. Disappear. As soon as I start looking this shit up, disappear, start popping up. You see what I'm saying? A lot of those disappearance be in Alaska, South Carolina, Arizona, Oregon. And down there in Arizona, you got those superstition mountains and shit. And we talked about that one time, Jacob Walsh, the Lost Dutchman and shit. And over 200-300 people done went missing in Arizona just off that story. Okay? But these are the 50 states that got the most missing people. You see, again, you see Oklahoma, here you see Mississippi, South Carolina, Utah, North Carolina got a bunch of missing people. Okay, now hold on. Let me find this one. My bad. Let me find this one. So it says the National Missing Persons Day was observed on February 5th. No, February 3rd. It was designed to give the nation an opportunity to focus more on finding those missing persons in some states, or even expanding those efforts. Arizona holds the missing day each year, holds an Arizona missing day each year. Each year, where forensic experts and law enforcement take information and notes and records about missing individuals in hopes of finding some of those people. Okay. Then you go here. Hold on. Let me get that back. Let me pull that back. So you go here. Hold on. Let me pull up. Let me pull up. Okay, right here. It says February 21st, 2019 at 10:53 a.m. Albany, Georgia, according to NAM US, over 600,000 people go missing each year in the US. 600,000 people go disappear in the US. And saying ranging from young children to older individuals. Famous missing persons cases such as Elizabeth Smart and Jamie Cross disappearance are well-known missing person cases, but countless other cases never make it to the spotlight. National Missing Persons Day observed on February 3rd. It was designed to give the nation the opportunity again for finding missing people. Okay? Which states have the most missing persons cases? Now we just went over that. As we see, it's Alaska and then Arizona. And then Arizona. And we gonna, because I'm gonna play that video in a minute and I'm gonna show you why. Okay? So again, over 600,000 people go missing in the United States each year. But listen here. Number of NCIC missing person files in the United States from 1990 to 2019. Okay. So in 2019, you had 600,900 people go missing. In 2018, you had 600,1200 people go missing. You had in 2017, you had 600,051 went missing. You got in 2016, you got 600,047 went missing. So in just 4 years, man, in 4 years, you got, look, six, 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 six. So you talking about damn near 25 million people done went missing in 4 years. This hold on. Hold on, hold on. Hold on, let me get that right. Yeah. Five, damn near 5 million people done went missing in 4 years. 4 years. Now hold on now. Cause we getting into this shit. Now look. These is, hold on, let me blow that up this way. Let me blow that up this way. Hold on. Okay, so hold on, white Caucasian every year, 6,284 people of the Caucasian race go missing, and 4,300 of those are female, are white females. Okay, then. Of course, their numbers gonna be higher in America because they number over what 300 and some thousand people. Okay, then you look at the African American, which ain't but 13% of the population, only about what about 45 million people. 1,290 people go missing every year, and 1,041 of those are female, and so on. Then you got the Hispanic, 1,719, 856 of them are females. Then you got the Asian, 205 of them go missing, 165 of those are female. Then you got some Hawaiians, two males, maybe five females. Then you know, uncertain and not proven, 39 and 16. Then you got American Indian and Native American, 214, 123 is a female, and then other you got 127 and 76, which totals out to 9,000 880 people and 6,582 of them are female. Damn, where all these damn people going? Okay, where all these damn people going? Okay, now 15,200 people of the U.S. are currently missing. Approximately 60,000 are male, 40,000 are female. The average age of people when they go missing is around the age 34. Damn, them grown people, them grown 15,000 of them people are grown people. As of January 2019, there are 106 children missing currently. Were younger than a year old when they went missing. So they stealing young babies, man, in the U.S. What are they doing with them children? Now, this the part I want to get to right here. So, as you can see, it says the top map shows cases of disappearing, people disappearing without a trace. The bottom map shows America's cage systems. Look at this. That's what I was talking about when I was talking about watching the movie Time Machine. Okay? And so if you look at the top map, all over America, this is where people missing. But then you see on the bottom in the where it's dark blue it, these are America's cage systems. And everywhere is and in national parks. The government need to clean this shit up, though I think they got something to do with. In national parks, all over America, all over Yellowstone, all that shit, all over America, they do not have no mandate or no papers where they keep the missing persons. They go, if you go missing in the national park, you just go missing. Because they don't even keep up with who go missing in national parks. They're just facts. Well, if you go to a national park and going camping and all that goofy shit, and you go missing, the government don't even count your ass is missing. They don't even keep up with who go missing in national parks. Okay? And if you look at this map on the top, you see all around these cage systems in these national parks, people are going missing. It don't matter who you is and shit. Who you is. I'm going to come back to this right here because I want to run this video right quick. Now let me bounce out of here and we're going to come right back to this now. Drop out. Let me get back over here. Now, we come back to here now. So I want to play this clip and I'm going to let it run. And, you know, put down in the comments what you think, but we're going to go back to that other clip. Hold up, let me tell y'all about this shit before we, Time Machine, before we go on. Now, in the movie, I ain't gonna go on, but in the movie Time Machine, this man trying to go back in time and fix a situation with his old lady, his queen, you know, that got killed. And he go into the future. On this particular scene right here, I'm not going to go through the whole movie. Just go watch. And on this particular scene right here, he going to the future. And the earth is, like they say, global warming and shit. And the sun done came closer to the earth. And everybody without melanin, because I'm not, and it's a key scene in here that I want y'all to see. Everybody without melanin gonna have to go live under the ground. Now, I heard the brother said he talk about this one time, but I never watched the movie. He never explained it, so I won't explain this shit for y'all. And these, you know, like I said, everybody would had to live underground. If you ain't got no melanin, when as the sun get closer and closer to Earth, you're gonna have to go under the ground. And the people that went under the ground done transformed into some monsters, basically. Into the Bigfoot, into a Sasquatch or whatnot. And they live in these caves where these peoples is going missing. And all the melanated African beings that's on the planet live on top of the earth. And so this is what you basically gonna be seeing in this scene. Now, but I want y'all to pay attention in here. And I'm gonna play the video. It's a scene in here where the Sasquatch shoot one of the African women, and her blood is black, which is a symbol of melanin. It's a symbolism of melanin, and it's showing you what it is. So I'm gonna play the video, and I'm gonna come right back. Now, you see that when he shot that girl with that arrow, you seen she had the melanin blood. You seen she had that melanin blood, and, you know, they were snatching them and pulling them into them cave systems. So I ask you again, you know, how is all these people going missing in America, man? If you look at the top, is the missing cases that's done been reported in America, I think what that thing say, since 2016, and it was what, over 5 million people. So, who is Sasquatch real and shit? See, you laugh when I say that. But go look at the video, stroll way down there. It's like a 3-hour video I got up there. And I'm talking about that. Talking about on how if, you know, people go, you know, back into their primitive ways up in them caves and shit, they gonna turn into the caveman. They gonna turn into Sasquatch. That's facts. The purple people eaters and shit. See? Y'all thought all that was fairy tale, but see, that's real. And y'all, they be reporting that Sasquatch shit all over the Americas and all over the world. But you see what what you think, a bass pulling everybody or a bobcat is stealing everybody? Man, I done watched every one of those missing shows and shit. And they always be saying that these people be going missing in the woods, you know, again on them, you know, these national parks and shit. And then y'all be talking about, you know, oh, well, you know, we going camping. Man, I ain't never, ever, ever going camping. Period. Because how you know what's in them damn woods? How you know what's in them woods? If you go out there in the woods, family, even to go fishing, have that thing on you. Because you going to end up missing, man. I'm telling you. I be telling. Like my mom and my brothers and them, they like to go out in the bushes and shit and go fishing and shit. And I go sometime too. But guess what? King gonna have that tang. And hey, if anybody go missing, it's gonna be whoever come up on the king, because ain't none of that shit going on. But seriously, family, look at this, man. This is facts. Look at this. The bottom one is the cave systems in America. And if you line them both up and you look at it, all down there in Arizona, around the mountains and caves and shit. You know, and then you look at the movie. What was that one movie called? And I'm going to end right here. Damn. Wrong turn. The people that live in the hills and shit. Eyes from the hills and shit. See? And then and they snatching them into them cave systems, eating on them. So y'all make sure y'all like, subscribe, and share. Keep an eye on your children. Keep an eye on your damn self. Because you might end up missing. Drop out!